Hey guys, in today's Book to Screen, I'm going to be talking about Gone Girl, based off of the book by Gillian Flynn, starring Ben Affleck and Rosamund Pike. Just to give you a quick idea of what Gone Girl is even about, on the day of their fifth wedding anniversary, Nick Dunn's wife Amy goes missing, and of course he is put in suspicion. And the question is, did he have anything to do with the disappearance of his wife? You guys, Gone Girl, the movie, I think was a terrific and pretty much perfect adaptation. And the best thing is that Gillian Flynn herself wrote the screenplay. You know, I think authors need to write the screenplay for movies more often, because authors are the ones who know their own books inside and out, so it almost makes sense that they should be the ones to write the movie adaptations. Authors know exactly what's important, what's not important, and what will work and won't work in a movie adaptation. But yeah, I freaking loved Gone Girl. Just so well done from start to finish. Even though it's close to 3 hours long, I don't think it ever felt that long. I think it moved along at a really good pace, very much like the book. And the thing is, if you have read the book, you know that there is tons and tons of stuff that is constantly happening in the book. Things that are constantly changing, things that are constantly being manipulated. So that all kind of just flows very well in the movie, and that's what keeps it moving. Because I think pretty much everything that happened in the book does happen in the movie. So, like I said, it is, I think, a near-perfect adaptation. I also really love the casting choices. Ben Affleck was perfect as Nick Dunn. He just had that whole kind of douchebag husband thing going on perfectly. And then I also really loved Rosamund Pike as Amy. I wish I could get into more spoilers, but I can't. But let me just say that she was terrific. At first, her American accent was a bit grating, because the majority of things that I've seen her in, I've seen her with her British accent, so it was a little kind of like, oh, I had to get used to her American accent. And then I also really loved Neil Patrick Harris. You know, I typically see him in comedic roles like How I Met Your Mother, but Neil Patrick Harris was just terrific in this, and in a bit more dramatic role. And then I also really loved Tyler Perry. Tyler Perry probably stole quite a few scenes. But yeah, a very good ensemble cast. Everyone just worked so great with one another. I really liked the directing. I really liked the fact that Gillian Flynn herself wrote the screenplay. I also really liked the music. The music was very chilling and eerie on occasion. Sometimes there were a few moments where I felt like the music was a bit too loud and kind of overpowered some scenes. But in general, I did like the music. If you have read the book, you know that Gone Girl has some very dark and graphic subject matter. If you haven't read the book, be wary going into the movie, because there is a few occasions of nudity, mostly from women, and then from men you just see like their rear ends. And don't believe the rumors about Ben Affleck being like full frontal, because I was staring really hard and I didn't really see anything. He was mostly in shadow. And what's the most abundant is the use of the very graphic curse scene. It gets a little flamboyant in its language. But yeah, just some really graphic and intense material. And if you don't think you can handle that, then don't go see this. If you might just prefer it in the book format, where you don't have to visualize it so much. Like I keep saying, I think this was pretty much a near-perfect adaptation. Thing is, it might be too perfect for some people, because I know there's a lot of people who really like differences from book to screen. If you have read the book, the movie is pretty much an identical replica of the book. If you have not read the book, but you've always kind of been interested in reading the book, or maybe you haven't wanted to pick up the book for whatever reasons, I think just seeing the movie will be perfectly fine for you. You'll be able to see what all the big hype and fuss is. And what's interesting, if you have read the book is done in a particular format because it's told in dual narrative. You have Nick's perspective and then you have Amy's perspective through her diary formats. And going into the movie, I was very concerned about how that was even going to work. And surprisingly enough, it worked just amazingly. I don't know how they did it. So yeah, you were able to get those dual perspectives and it all worked in the confines of the movie, just like it does in the book. So have you guys read Gone Girl? Have you seen the movie adaptation? And what did you think? If you have seen the movie and you would like to get into more specifics and get into some more spoilers, that's perfectly fine with me. Just make sure somewhere in your comment you write like spoilers so that way anyone going through the comments won't accidentally see a spoiler. So that's it for this book to screen. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you liked this book to screen, you may like these other book to screens. Bye, guys.